We've talked about cheat days in the past, but what about cheat bites? You shouldn't even have a cheat bite. Hey there, NJRoute22.com here with another low-carb keto carnivore chat. And this is just a little bit of an expansion of a previous video we did about cheat days and cheat meals. It's gotten so bad with how carbs affect us that I don't think you should even afford yourself a cheat bite. I'll give you a couple examples here because I think it really does. Eating any kind of processed carb or refined carb in any way is not good for your mind, body, and soul. A couple personal examples that affected us recently. It was Thanksgiving a month and a half ago or so, and we brought over a nice prepared meal for my father. And you know, I wasn't planning on eating. I'm usually pretty satiated throughout the day. I just have my one serving of red meat, and I'm okay. But everybody's serving, and like I see these green bean casserole. It looked really good. I said, let me try some. And a couple lumps, small lumps of bready white bread stuffing made it onto my plate. And I ate them, and you could feel it like a virus overcome you. And like, it changes your hunger and satiation level to the point where I felt hungry for at least the rest of the day and part of the next day. It affected the way my body was talking to my brain, and my brain was telling me to eat more. And luckily I had enough self-control and I did not, but it was an uncomfortable feeling to have this artificial hunger. Because when I eat just, 4 ounces of nice red meat, I just stop eating and I don't think about food for many hours, most of the time, rest of the day, and that's fine. But the second thing happened recently as well. I cook a lot for my family, and I always make interesting dishes for them, and I make white rice, jasmine rice for my family, and sometimes I usually just season with a little maybe some scallions and some cilantro, a little bit of garlic perhaps. But I made them a tikka masala rice dish, and I tasted two bites of it, and I knew at that point, I'm like, wow, it overcame me, and I could have eaten that entire, I made a huge bowl like this big. I could have sat there like a horse eating out of a feeding bag, and I could have easily polished it away on autopilot. But again, I didn't do it. I'm like, man, you can really recognize how just a bite or two of these starchy carbs can just change your entire mindset and just your desire. You wanted to eat more. So this is why carbs lead to more carbs, and it's just not a healthy thing to do. And that's why carnivore is gaining like importance in our lives and many other people's lives, because you are in control of what you eat. And when your body isn't sending the wrong signals to your brain to eat more, you really understand it. And this is why I think it's important to go seriously zero carb. It doesn't have to be 100% carnivore, but you'll end up there. I promise you, you'll end up being carnivore, because once you feel how quickly the types of foods you eat affect your body and the choices you make, you'll realize that, and this is, I can go on and on, but it's amazing that just a bite or two of the bad carbs can totally change your self-control and so on. But luckily we held strong, and we're not doing it. So each time I make these mistakes, it makes me stronger next time. We have chips in the closet here. We have all sorts of bad foods that I just have to stop. You don't do it. You're like, no. You can see my previous video about this low-carb ricotta cheese I made. And that was low enough, it didn't affect my blood sugar, and you had a couple bites and you walked away. That's the worst I'm going to do from now on. It's going to be my meat, and that's that. So please hit the like and the subscribe and so on. And I'll see you next video.